Still there? Roll it.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the sportscast team. Standing at a strong 5'10 and a half. The best knuckle puck to come out of Truro, Nova Scotia. I present Mr. Matty Mac. And in the other corner, standing a mildly impressive 5'11, has the best free throw percentage in his driveway, I present you Isaac Habib. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Sports Cell. It is September 30th, last one of the month. My name is Matt, and I'm here with Isaac. Isaac, how you doing? Are you at the dock here, Jim, or are you home now?
I'm home now. Thank you. Working overtime and not going to get my time back. I'm a company man.
Big company, company man.
Big PSP. PSP all over me. PSP, baby.
Yeah, lots has happened in the sporting world in the last week. We got lots to talk about. I mean, the Stanley Cup has been handed out. Game one of the NBA championships starting tonight. We have the Jays in the midst of their best 2 out of 3. The NFL has been kicked off strong, going really well. Lots to talk about in the sporting world. I'm sure there's more. There's golf and everything else. Let's just touch on the military news, though, if you got anything first. Did the Ryder Cup get rescheduled?
October 13th. So we have the second day of that championship happening. If you're a base team golfer playing for Halifax or Shearwater, or if you're a really good golfer, send me your information, isaac.habib@forces.gc.ca. Also, what else do we all want to say? Oh, Mega Golf was pretty good. We had about 40 some odd people golfing. We're still tallying up the points. So we do have a winner from Shearwater, from Dockyard, and from Stad, because we usually crown a top unit. So I'll be in contact with you to kind of get a team photo and trophy and all that stuff.
You don't have the winners right now?
I do, just not off the top of my head right now, no.
Okay.
We all know that Mega is about participation, so thank you all out there that submitted all your golfers and all that. Ryder Cup, we're not looking for any golfer, okay? We're looking for scratch golfers. We're looking for people that are ready to compete, okay? So send me your information. Also, intersection curling. If you're interested in curling, anyone can join. If you're not belonging to a unit or a team, that's okay. We can take your name down as spares and add you to a list. So get your information out to me. That's again, my name is Isaac Habib. I'm the sports coordinator at the Dockyard Gym for CFB Halifax. Thank you.
Big company, man. It'd be kind of nice to have the names of the winners, you know, when we come on the show. Like, it might be nice to be prepared, maybe. Next time.
Yeah, well, we don't have it announced yet, so I can't really announce it right now. There's a couple things you don't really understand about the sports world. Like, because you're part of the wannabe sports world, which we call recreation.
Yeah, gotcha. Gotcha. Yeah. That's good. Lots going on. So we got the intersection hockey. We're still taking teams and still taking players if you want to play. That's in the evenings, Monday to Thursday. At the Shearwater Arena, and we are just moving up to 5-on-5 play starting next week. So that'll be 5-on-5, and still free military and D&D employees only, though. But yeah, you're still welcome to get your name in on a team or enter a team of your own. Still lots of space for that.
super.
All right, Lightning.
No, I got to mention something. Football. Okay. Did you hear about football, Titans, and the Steelers?
Yeah, I heard something, yeah.
It's been suspended. It's been suspended because of a potential, COVID outbreak. So they may reschedule that for Monday or Tuesday, which is interesting because, I still feel like they won't have a Super Bowl. But we'll see what happens as this goes on.
Is that your prediction? Is that a hot take right here?
I would say, the way the NFL is going, it's all good right now. But if things get a bit messier and a bit more complicated and things get suspended and rescheduled, well, it's a good chance you may not see a Super Bowl. Who knows? Hopefully not. I'd like to see a Super Bowl. But they're not in a bubble. They're not like NHL or NBA, so it'll be interesting.
But the MLB is not in a bubble either, aren't they? And they're playing games.
No, they're not either. Yeah, you're right. But, that doesn't mean that it can't happen with NFL.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
Football.
That's fair.
Yeah. Other than that, let's get right into it. So, toughest cup? Is that the toughest cup to win?
Was that a headline? Someone told me that too. Someone said it was. No, I'm saying no.
No?
Listen, I'm coming full circle. We had a conversation before all this started about the Asterix and about should there be an Asterix this year and whatever. And I said no. I said every time they hand it out, it is what it is. But I think I'm coming full circle and saying it doesn't feel the same. It doesn't feel right.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm kind of coming the other way right now with hockey. I don't think this translates over to basketball, which we'll talk about. I find if you look at Tampa specifically, last year, what did they do? They were like the best team and they got swept by Columbus, right?
Yeah.
I think that was what happened. And then like a few years back, 2018, 2016, like we don't have anyone that fact checks on this show here. But something like that, 2016, 2018, they were the team, and they lost. And here they are again, 2020. We said, hey, this is their year to kind of break through. It's not a real year, but I think the bubble might be tough, not seeing your family. And it is a different dynamic. And the fact that they did win, I guess, is impressive. But, again, if you were to tell me the same thing about the NBA, like if the Heat or the Lakers win, well, I think it depends. It depends on the team and each personal like journey for that team. You know what I mean?
So you're waiting to see if the Lakers win, you're going to call it an Asterix.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
That doesn't make sense. That's flawed.
I just told you it's a personal journey and personal to each context of the sport. Like Tampa winning, well, I'm not mad at that. I think that some things that happened, like Boston being eliminated,
Pittsburgh, Washington, Toronto, Edmonton.
But look who Tampa played again. Look who they played. Who'd they play? And then some of those games that they won, they blew out teams like 8-2, 7-1. I think that was Boston. Could be wrong. I'm just saying, they're blowing out teams. They're not playing easy teams. Stanley Cup is it?
They played the Islanders. They played the Islanders in the conference final. Who thought the Islanders were supposed to be there? No one.
What are you mad about that no one was like cheering when they put the Stanley Cup over their head? Like that was stupid and boring. But I mean, that might be the different feeling. I don't know.
No.
Also.
Go ahead.
What?
I like when you ask the question and then you keep talking so I can't answer.
No, but like, you ask me, like, is that a headline? Is that a headline? No, I don't think so. Well, I'm asking you, is it one of the toughest Stanley Cups to win in this situation versus other years?
No, teams didn't have to play an 82-game regular season. And this goes the same with basketball as well. I would have the same argument. You don't have to go through the 82-game season to make it to the playoffs. They have a huge rest in between, months off, and then they come back, and it's a completely different format. I like your idea of having like a COVID cup or, you know, some sort of special trophy for this year. But like, you have Boston, who was the best team in the regular season, but then they come in and they do these round robin to reseed the top four teams. Like, and now, so Boston, yeah, I think, finished fourth in that.
Yeah.
So they have a harder matchup based on three games, and they missed playing like 30 in the regular season.
So for 20 episodes, I'm telling you Asterix, and then on the 21st episode, I'm like, you know what? I've been thinking about it, and you flopped on me. Okay, that's good. Let me ask you another question.
Before the show, we always have to disagree. If you say something, I have to disagree with you.
I know.
No, I'm just kidding.
Follow-up question. If the season starts in January, like they're proposing, and they do 82 games, right? Like whatever the NHL is thinking of doing. What if Tampa wins again? Like say, or what if maybe Boston comes out and wins or something like that. Don't you think that'll tell you more of a story about what just happened in COVID?
If they play,
you know what I mean? Like, if they play a snapshot of like 2020, 21, 22, like, and they were like, if you looked at stats and stuff, could you go back maybe and say, oh, you know what? Maybe there isn't an asterisk. Do you know what I'm saying? Like a full picture.
I think you got to take it year by year. I don't think you look at a snapshot. I think if they play 82 games, and it's going to be a condensed season, which is going to be even more difficult for the players, and then they play a regular playoffs, like if it's the same, you want to be able to, like, if LeBron wins, I kind of get it that it's maybe an asterisk, because you want it to be, like, Jordan had a harder time to win his championships based on the amount of games and whatever, rather than
Don't worry. We're gonna talk basketball. Don't worry.
Well, it's the same concept. You could use anyone. You could use Gretzky. Like, it doesn't matter. They had to.
Okay, but what happens if they play 82 games next year? It's still not the same. I mean, still,
you could argue that it's more difficult.
They award the Stanley Cup after June. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah. But that's what I'm saying. So if you're gonna play, and I think that's why Montreal brought in Jake Allen. To have two goalies, because there's going to be games where there's back-to-backs where Carey can't play every game. So, yeah, if you play 82 games in a season, you don't do this random round-robin or play-in round where the 12th seed takes out the 5th seed in both conferences, and now you have Edmonton, who's 5th, and just because they took a couple months off, like Draisaitl was the best player this year. They take a couple months off, they get bounced in a best-of-five series.
Yeah.
That doesn't happen. Chicago doesn't make the playoffs. That doesn't happen.
I'm with you. I agree with you. I'm just saying there might be a special case with Tampa because they've been knocking on the door the last 5 years.
I'll ask you this question.
And here they are.
I'll ask you this question.
The best team.
Maybe the question that comes to me is, did Tampa Bay need a COVID year to win the cup, because they weren't able to do it any other year where it was a regular season with a playoff where everyone, like Tuukka Rask, had to leave because of family health concerns.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
And Stamkos didn't play most of the playoffs.
Okay, but doesn't that make things harder, potentially? Hey, you know, like, people are in the bubble. Some people are not showing up. Some people got to leave. You know what I mean? I'm just wondering, you know.
They're living better in the bubble than you and I every day.
Are they on Tinder? Okay, all right. Well,
no, my question, obviously, that's a serious question about, did it take a COVID year for the Tampa Bay Lightning to win a Stanley Cup?
That's why I'm asking you, though. In January, if they start a new season, and they say they ended up winning the 2021 season, like say they won that, wouldn't that be impressive? You would go back and say, well, hey, maybe there wasn't an asterisk on that COVID cup.
We can look back at this tape in a year and we'll see.
I hope we still got jobs in a year. Okay. Well, anyway, I think that was, I heard another fact here. That was the first time Batman was not booed when he did his speech.
That's, yeah, that makes sense. I'm sure he was at home, but
pretty good joke.
It's a pretty good joke.
Yeah, it was a pretty good joke. Yeah, okay, cool. What else you want to talk about hockey wise? Are you done?
Like, you got.
I mean, it is what it is, right? They won 2-0 against Dallas. I mean, again, Dallas has been knocking on the door too, so I'll make an argument that maybe they deserve to be in the from the West. I don't know.
No.
Yeah, probably not.
Obviously, okay, okay, like, okay. I hate to take credit away from teams when they work so hard. Like, I love to see a team that shouldn't be there get there. Like, the Islanders, I was cheering for the Islanders because they shouldn't have been there. But it's just not the same. Like, Tampa Bay, who they play in the first round? I forget.
For the Habs. See, like, if the Habs won, Habs weren't supposed to be there. Tampa?
Yeah, who'd they play in the very first round? I think
you're Tampa played Columbus?
You got a bit of a delay. Yeah, it was right. It was a redemption year. Yeah, you're right. I think there's a bit of a delay here.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they played a Columbus team.
You're delayed.
They played a Columbus team who got into the playoffs, but they shouldn't have been there because they beat the Leafs out in the play-in round. So they shouldn't have been in the playoffs. Well, I guess, no. Yeah, that's how it worked, right? So they played
a
Columbus team who shouldn't have been there. They then play a Boston team in the second round with Tuukka Rask leaving the team. Now, Halak's a good goalie, but that definitely caused some unsettling. They then go on to play the Islanders, who are, like, why are they in the Eastern Conference Final? Okay? They're a good team. They're a good, well-rounded team. Who's best player? Matt Barzal, obviously. But then what? Then who do you got?
I mean, if they don't have Tavares, they shouldn't be there. You know what I mean? I was like, why are the Islanders
And then you
there?
Go on to then you go on to play Dallas, who... We all said from the very start, likely not to go very far. They have a good team. They have a good first line, but they're likely not to go deep in the playoffs. We're like, do you not see what I'm getting at? Like, it doesn't feel right.
Yeah, I've been saying that, like I said, for 20 episodes straight. I'm just saying, in hindsight, seeing Tampa win, like, we're going to talk basketball. I kind of have the same idea if Miami beats the Lakers. Like, if Miami beats the Lakers, are you going to take that away from... Maybe you take away the championship that they've won. Is the relative humidity like 99% right now? Holy smokes.
I'm sweating too, man. Look, look at that forehead, man. Holy.
Can someone check the barometric pressure here or what? Jesus. All right. What was I saying? Oh, if the Heat win, speaking of Heat, am I right?
Jesus.
If the Heat win, you know, it's impressive. They take out the Lakers. Now, do they deserve to be there and how they got there? And well.
What? I will say that the NBA, I do enjoy how they did. They had 8 games when they came back into the bubble. They had an 8-game finish to the regular season. So they played like a bulk of their regular season. I don't know how many games. Let's say 50 games. They come back in. They play 8 more. Each team plays 8 more games that they brought invited back to the bubble. So you're still in a regular season. It's almost like a lockout year. Like, you're still playing just right. There's no play-in where you're knocking out teams. Now, there would have been there. You know what I mean? I guess there technically was with the 8 and 9 seed. But that's a close, like, that's, I get it. Not a 12-5. Okay?
Let's talk basketball. Okay?
We're in it. I'm in it. It just feels different than how the NHL.
Was there any bubble pressure? Was there any bubble pressure on Milwaukee and the Clippers?
No.
You don't think that no bubble pressure?
How? Explain how.
I'm just curious to how a team like Milwaukee and the Clippers get eliminated.
Because they're not good. Listen, the shooting percentage has been higher this playoff because every time Danny Green's in the corner, there's no one in his ear. There's no fans in his ear yelling at him. Like, the shooting percentages have been higher. Baseball scores have been higher. Like, things have been higher, and I feel like because the stage, it's still a big stage, but there's not 20,000 people.
Higher. I've been higher. Okay, quick headline here. Do you hear about Doc Rivers?
Yeah.
He met with the 76ers.
Did he meet with them?
And he's one of the guys that they're looking at him for a head coach.
He position. Won't be called Doc, though, if he goes there.
What will he be called?
Glenn Rivers. I guess Philadelphia is right sensitive about the name Doc because I forget who it was. It might have been, I don't know who
Doc
they call
Holiday?
Yeah, that would make sense. But they said there's only one Doc in Philly. And so I don't know if we'll call him Doc Rivers or Glenn Rivers, but anyway.
Yeah, that's, you know who that is. It's the doctor. Jones. You don't know the Jones, doctor.
All right, let's move on here. Let's get to relevant basketball.
Man. Well, study your stuff. Anyway, okay, big night tonight, right? You're gonna stay up like to see the.
I don't think, man.
Jump ball at 11 o'clock tonight.
Listen. We got Lakers and Miami. I got a couple of things I wrote down here. Here are the storylines. So we got the obvious one of LeBron playing Spoelstra, his old coach, and the ownership there, Riley, or whatever his name was, right? Basically, what it gets to there is that when LeBron and D-Wade and Bosh all went to Miami, they all sat down Pat Riley basically said, like, you know, you can't screw us over. Like, this is what it's going to be for a year, whatever it is. Like, we're costing us assets for doing this and yada, yada, yada. And then they ends up leaving, right? So they ended on bad terms because he did leave probably before he said he would. So it's kind of interesting in that sense. We got Bam versus Davis. There's a lot of excitement about that matchup. Bam Adebayo and Anthony Davis. And then people are talking about Iggy shutting down his impact on LeBron, as that was popular in his Golden State years.
Who's shutting down LeBron?
Iggy.
Iguodala?
Yeah. That's a storyline because that's what his job. Iguodala won a Finals MVP because he shut down LeBron. Now that's the stupidest thing I've ever heard of. Finals MVP should be the best player. Kawhi shouldn't have got the Finals MVP because he shut down Kawhi. Give it to Tim Duncan. Give it to Giannobli. I don't know.
How many finals was Andre Iguodala a part of?
Probably all of them with the Golden State Warriors. I don't know.
I think he. I'll have to look it up.
The last one I got was Jay Crowder getting revenge on LeBron because he traded him out of Cleveland after 4 months in the Kyrie deal. So I don't think Crowder was happy with that or something. I don't know. I just love the drama.
Yeah, so you mentioned a lot of good things there. I like just from face value, Pat Riley, Spoelstra, the Heat versus LeBron and the Lakers. You know, I like that storyline. I want them to win, obviously. It's interesting, Jimmy Butler, they're asking him, hey, how do you feel like, you know, being the underdogs, we heard you don't like being called the underdogs. What do you like being called? And Jimmy Butler's like a really good team. I mean, we're all NBA players. I don't know why they're calling us the underdogs. So there's something real about the Miami Heat. They're a team, and we all know teams win championships. Like, we can break down the Lakers. We can break down LeBron and Davis, but what we should be talking about tonight is all the supporting cast, all the wild cards. What are they going to do? We already know what LeBron and Davis are going to do. What's Kuzma going to do? Is Danny Green going to make his shots? That's what's going to be interesting because LeBron's going to get his points in the paint. There's no stopping him. But it'd be nice to see the matchups. Like, is Bam going to be on Davis? Is Crowder going to be on him? Like, what's the situation?
It's going to be interesting for sure. Who do you got? Who's your pick?
I want to say Heat in six, and Bam is the MVP.
Wow, bold.
I just think the key for Miami, even though, like, we can break down, like, We need Dragic, this old dude who doesn't look like he's old. He's super quick, and he's getting his points. We got to see, what's his name? Robinson? Duncan Robinson?
Yeah. He's a baller, man.
Make his shots. Yeah. I love Tyler Hero. I love what Jimmy Butler's doing. If all those guys together put it together, you know, that's going to be great. But I think it's got to be around Bam. They're so young. These guys are so young, 23 years old, 21 years old. That's what kind of worries me, is that you got LeBron James with it's not LeBron James of, like, 2008, where he's, like, running down in the paint and wanting to dunk on everyone. Like, I was reading about this earlier today, that the Pistons were saying how predictable he was. The Spurs were saying how predictable LeBron was. Now watch him. Did you see him against the Nuggets? Pick and roll. Pick and roll. He'll wait all day. He's patient. He's mature. And he's going to the line. It's going to be a three-point play. I don't care how hard you hit him or what happens. He's going to finish. But I think the stat that people are saying is that if you can limit him from passing, can you chop down his assists? Because he's going to score 40.
Yeah, he definitely has to be a big part of the win if they're going to win. I think I'm going to go with the Lakers 5 or 6 games. I don't think it gets very far. I think LeBron's hungry for a fourth title. I think he needs it for his legacy. What do you think it means if he doesn't win? I know you're a big Jordan fan and obviously over LeBron, but what do you think it means for LeBron's legacy? It doesn't even matter in comparison to being the greatest of all time, but just his legacy as a ball player. If he goes, he'll be now 3-7, right? 3 wins, 7 losses in the final. Yeah.
I think it's, sorry, I just moved my laptop there. I think it's really, really important for his, not just his legacy, but him as a Laker. Like, oh, that's great. You've been to 10 championships. You only won 3. That means you lost 7. You lost 7. Okay? Kobe was at, I think, in 7 and won 5. You know what I mean? Like, that's it. Michael Jordan, yeah. Unblemished. 6
we
finals.
We don't.
For me, everyone's counting, like, how many finals he's been in and how many playoffs. All that. For him as a Laker, he needs to win this. He can't lose to the Heat. This would be like losing to Dallas. He should have never lost to Dallas. Now, Dirk and them played really well, but he needs to win this. Then we can talk about Asterix and legacy, but this is something he needs to win. And I think he's hungry. You know, it's going to be a hard one to lose.
Yeah. It's interesting when you get talking about the records. Like, looking back on it, he lost 4 times to the Golden State Warrior dynasty. Like, you can't really fault him for that. That team with Durant, Curry, and Clay, like, Iguodala, you can't fault him for losing to, like, that squad. You know what I mean? He lost 4 times in the 2010s to the Golden State Warriors in the finals. And that's 4 of his 6 losses right now. He's 7, right? He's got 7 losses. And then the Spurs obviously shut him down. But, it's hard. I think he got swept once in the finals by the, like, it's just, man, I don't know if you can really fault the guy for that. That'd be, I guess you can, you have to, but.
I just think, I mean, we're going to get into something else here. I don't want to, but he's come a long way. He's developed. He's 35 years old. He probably looks the best he's ever looked. Like I'm saying, his IQ of the game has significantly improved. He's not just, like, dribbling and then, like, trying to dunk on everyone. He's, like, 3 plays ahead, and he knows how to do the pick and roll. It's so simple. It's just, like, it's so easy for when you have that kind of talent, and then when the team is doing that for you and helping you out. Like I said, his style of play, like, I think it's, like, 65% of his field goals come from in the paint. You know, he's not, like, a nice shooter like Kobe and Jordan was. I don't like his style. I don't even like his personality or his hairline, but do I think he's a dominant player? Yeah, he's a dominant player. He's going to be unstoppable. But I saw Dallas take him out early on. I see teams like the Spurs. Like, it's going to depend on, you know, Bam and these guys and what they can do defensively. Those guys rolled through Celtics that were injured and weak up front. So the Lakers are a different story.
I think the
what happens when the Lakers go small, right? What happens when they go small?
Who? How do you go small in the Lakers?
Like, you know, if they were to go out with Rondo and these guys, and you know, not have like the Howard and the McGee, you know, at certain times of the games, like can.
What about AD? You got AD. You got like.
Yeah, they should win. They should win the championship. You should give it to them right now. But that's the thing. It'll be, you know, I think Miami's a solid squad. And, you know, Duncan Robinson right now, I'm not comparing him to Steph Curry and Klay Thompson, but he's shooting the highest three-point percentage right now.
Yeah, I think you almost should. I think they're almost – they remind me of a Golden State light version. Like, they're a light version of – the squad, the shooters on the team, Hero's obviously a three-point specialist. Robinson, Crowder shooting pretty good from three, too. Like, the whole team can shoot from three, and I think that's what they have over the Lakers right now. The Lakers have a few guys. Danny Green, he's kind of – anyway, you can have your opinions of Danny Green. And I mean, they'll hit their occasional threes, but, yeah, Duncan Robinson, some of these guys are made for that. Like, that's their job on the team. So you could see how – that's the thing that I think that worries me most. LeBron, you saw how he fared against the Golden State Warriors, which was their style, and I think this is a light version of that. I mean, you got Bam, so it's a bit different, but yeah, I think they're a light version of the Golden State Warriors.
I think, honestly, like a lot of things have to happen and click, you know, whether it's luck or however it works out. LeBron has to be forced to shoot, if you can. I don't know how that's going to happen, but if you can force him out of the paint, force him to shoot. These wild cards like Kuzma and Green, if they just go like they don't do well and do what they're supposed to do, that's excellent, right? Of course, because you need that. You need those guys to make those shots. And look out for like the Heat. The Heat is a well-balanced squad. I never thought that early on, but now that I've been watching them, and maybe I was wrong, and maybe people knew this early on, but They win through some teams. You know, okay, yeah, the Celtics had some injuries and stuff, but they're playing together like one of the best teams right now in the NBA. And if Bam, holy, Bam has some sweet, huge jumpers, man. He's a big rebounder, and he can just like, he's got the sexiest dimes. He's like, what is he, 23? He's 23 years old. I'm all about these guys, man. I hope they give them a good run. I won't be mad at them losing if they give them a good run. I just don't want them to get swept or not show up.
Yeah, for sure. You're right though. They did go through a tough. They beat the Bucks. I wouldn't fault this. I don't think the Celtics were that injured. I know Hayward was out for a couple of games and he probably didn't come back 100%. But they still beat, like, it was Tatum and Brown. You know what I mean? Like, they still beat a pretty good Celtics team. That Celtics team beat the Raptors, which, you know, whatever. I don't know who Miami played in the first round. I can't remember right now.
Bucks.
That was the first round? Oh, yeah. Was that 1-8?
Oh, man.
Let me get my notebook. Where's my – oh, it's in the car. My notebook's in the car.
Yeah, let me get my notebook here. You keep talking. Oh, wait. Oh, BRP.
They played the Bucks in the second round is what they did, by the way.
Is that what they did?
Yeah.
Miami and Indy. They played the first round. They played against Indy.
So, yeah, I mean, that was – I don't know. I forget how many games that went, but they were – like, they're a decent squad. It's just like your typical first-round matchup, depending on where you placed in 1-8. So, you know what I mean? You work in the right regular season for your playoff matchup. But yeah, I think they had a good road to the final. I think the Lakers, people are saying, you know, they're 4-1 in every series. I don't think they had an easy road, like some people are saying. I think Portland, they ran into Dame. Dame was averaging 50 points a game in his last two or three games in the bubble, like in that 8-game regular season or whatever it was, or he was averaging.
Easy road.
He was averaging over 50 points, and they ran into Dame. But that's a 1-8 seed, so sure, like five, they beat them in five. That's awesome. You can call that an easy win, sure. But Dame was hot. Second round, you play the Rockets. The Rockets were a contending team this year. Rockets were expected to be up there, and they beat them in five. I was happy to see that. I'm not a big Rocket fan, but that's not an easy win. Like, and then the Nuggets were a workhorse this year. And that series, if 80 doesn't hit that game winner, then the Nuggets are now up 2-1 in that series. At one point.
Yeah, is he going to do that? Is he going to do that against the Heat? Like, these are the question marks, right? He's got to hit those jumpers.
Yeah, and is Bam going to be able to block a LeBron dunk, not a Jason Tatum dunk, in the last dying seconds of the game to seal the win? Like, it's the same thing on both sides.
Not really when you got the refs in your pocket. I mean, you got LeBron James who will fire the coach, fire his teammates, threaten to go to another team if he doesn't get his way. So, I mean, no, I don't think it's weighted pretty fairly. I mean, as soon as he gets in the line, there were some phantom calls. I'm telling you, there's phantom calls against LeBron, unlike anyone I've ever seen. Phantom.
I don't know about that.
That means like ghost. That means ghost, like that you can't see it. That's what.
Yeah, I can pick that up. Yeah, I don't know about that, but.
What's the relative humidity right now, though? That's what I want to know. Like, I'm soaked right now.
It's October. It's almost October, so it's okay.
That's okay. It's flu season. I'm gonna get. Maybe I have a fever right now.
Yeah, I think that's a pretty good breakdown of the first.
I'm excited.
Of the finals.
Excited.
Are you watching the games or are you going to bed?
I think I'm going to check some of it out. I won't finish it.
Yeah.
I'm going to check out tonight's game. I just kind of want to see the tip off on all that. But I'll probably do a YouTube highlight video tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
And I think they play on Friday. I'll watch that for Shizzle.
Yeah, all the games are starting at 10. Atlantic Standard Time, except for the Sunday, I think is an 8:30 or 9:30 start. Super late for us East Coasters, but it's all geared for the West Coast people. But yeah, so 10 o'clock tonight, you have the Lakers and Heat playing off game one. Right before we go, I was looking up a few things just to wrap up here. The trade bait board in the NHL, so it's now off season time in the NHL, and Patrick Laine is probably one of the biggest. Yeah, I don't know when the season's going to start, but Patrick Laine is probably the biggest name on the trade bait board. So there's been some mock deals thrown out. How would you feel if he went to the Habs?
Oh, my goodness. Let's do. Who are we giving up?
So I've seen some mock deals floating around online, and here's what I found. So to Winnipeg, Domi, Mete, and a 2020 first-round pick. And I don't know where they pick in the first round, but you lose Max Domi and Mete. And a first-round pick this year, and you get just Laine coming in return for that. Would you do that deal?
Yeah, I would take him.
Laine would have three other Finns on.
He's a talent.
He would have
three
Finns on the Canadians with him. So I mean, I'm sure that's kind of a nice fit for him too, right? Some other ones here, going to Edmonton, Patrick Laine for Nugent Hopkins and a first-round pick. Oilers get that first-line winger that they've been looking for to play with McDavid. And Winnipeg gets a second-line center who they've definitely been missing. That's another option. There's a bunch of them. I'll just give you one more here. The LA Kings.
Bust that team up. Bust the Oilers up.
Well, so yeah, that's an interesting blueprint. You'd have Draisaitl, McDavid, and Laine. It's kind of a similar formula to the Toronto Maple Leafs with their big three or four. And you've seen how well that has worked or hasn't worked, I guess, for the Toronto Maple Leafs. So it's an interesting formula. Would they go through with it? I have a big Edmonton Oilers fan friend who said yeah. I don't know. Like, Patrick Laine had a great start. Yeah, I think he's a goal scorer. I think you put him with McDavid, he's getting 50 goals a year.
What if Edmonton wore Leaf jerseys and like the Leafs wore Edmonton jerseys? Do you think that would make a difference?
Maybe. I think the blue on the Leafs might slow them down a bit more.
I say you got to bust those teams up. Bust
Why?
Them both up. Well, like the Leafs, for instance, they tried that. Didn't work. Babcock said, give me a few years. They didn't give him a few years. They didn't give him any. He had a young crew. Give him a few years. See what happens. They didn't give it to him.
Yeah, he was harassing the players.
Everyone harasses players. It's part of the culture. about the harassment there. I don't know about all that.
just a disclaimer. The last one I'll give you, the Kings get Patrick Laine. Winnipeg gets a second overall pick this year, who is Quinton Byfield likely to be, and then a third pick in 2021 and Matt Roy, who I don't know who it is. I think it's a defenseman. I mean, I guess it's really Byfield, but they get the second line center. He's highly valued as a prospect. Anyway, interesting deals. I think the Kings are a front runner.
Patrick Laine, get him over here. We need you on the right wing, bruh.
Let's reach out to him. Let's reach out to his agent, see if we can bring him on the show and see where he wants to end up.
Do you think he would do this?
He went on SportsCenter, so I don't see why not.
We could give him like a PSP shaving kit or a toothbrush. Oh, we could give him a $5 Tim's card. He would do it for a $5 Tim's card.
Oh, man, he's got to get really competitive first, though, and get really mad at people.
How about a movie pass for one?
Yeah, it's only, maybe. We'll see how he is on the show first.
All right, cool.
All right, I think that's a good intro to the finals and a good wrap-up of the Lightning. Obviously, lots more to go for discussion. And we're in the off-season with the NHL. Off-season for the NBA is coming up. I think that'll be really interesting. I think, there's been a lot of talk about... It's time to move Harden as well, James Harden from the Rockets. There's trouble there. There's definitely trouble in Houston. Westbrook was not the answer. CP3 was way better than Westbrook. But anyway, the offseason is going to be really fun.
Are you saying Houston, we have a problem? Is that what you're saying right there?
You're supposed to have, man, you got to have kids before you can use dad jokes. Like, you can't just keep
Isn't
using
that
dad
what
jokes.
You just said Houston. We have a problem, like you're Tom Hanks.
All right, anyway, cool. Anyway, throw it in the towel here.
I say we go every night.
Hey, let's watch the games, and I'll wave my towel in the crowd like this.
Oh man, everyone would love that. I think they'd rather a cardboard cutout than you.
All right, let's wrap it up here. Thanks for coming on, and thanks for everyone for tuning in. We'll be seeing you next Wednesday, and good luck to the Lakers and the Heat. And congrats
thank
to Craig
you,
Hayden.
All three of you out there. See you, Craig. Good night. We love you.